Hey, you guys, wouldn't it be great if our investments only went up and we never ever experienced a loss? Now I realize that's unrealistic. So one of the questions I get sometimes is, what do you do when you have a loss? What if I buy a stock and it goes down a lot? Do I sell it? Do I hold it forever? What do I do? Now, those of you who watch my channel know I'm a buy and hold investor. Is I buy it and I hold it long term. Now, once in a while, I buy a security being an individual stock, an ETF, or a mutual fund, and it goes down. Now, if I have it in one of my tax advantage accounts, my Roth or my traditional IRA, I don't get to do anything with that because the taxes are already being saved, right? Because it's tax deferred or tax free, in the case of the Roth, right, tax free growth, the IRS doesn't let me do anything with those losses. Now, in that case, as long as I let it ride, hopefully it'll come back. If I don't sell it in the account, I don't realize the loss. But what about if I have a taxable account? What if I have a brokerage account? I've got all my tax advantage space filled up with investments, and now I'm investing in a taxable account. Now we can do something with those losses. If you're new to the channel, my name is Brad. We talk about investing here. Give me a thumbs up. Then consider subscribing to the channel. It really helps us out. So let's talk about what we can do with those losses. What is tax loss harvesting? Tax loss harvesting is selling of a security at a loss. And by realizing or harvesting the loss, we can use that to offset capital gains or ordinary income. If we don't have any capital gains, what does that mean? Well, remember the difference between short-term capital gains and long-term capital gains. If I hold a security for over a year, 366 days or more, it's a long-term gain, and those get taxed at a lower rate. Now, the short-term capital gains get taxed at our ordinary income level, so all the way up to 37%. These are the ones we want to try to save on. So let's say, for example, I bought XYZ stock and I bought 100 shares for $10,000 at the beginning of the year. Let's say I bought it on January 15th. Okay, so I have $10,000 investment in XYZ stock. It's a tech stock, let's say, okay? And let's say it has a really bad year and it drops all the way down to $7,000 in value. I have a $3,000 loss on that stock purchase. Now, I can sell that stock and I can harvest the $3,000 loss. Let's say I had another stock, let's say it was Coca-Cola. Now, I'm using this just as an example, you guys, but let's say Coca-Cola went up $3,000 this year. And for whatever reason, I decided I wanted to sell it because I felt it wasn't gonna go up anymore. I could use the $3,000 loss to offset the $3,000 gain from the other stock. But there are a few rules because the tax man always knows how people use this to their advantage. Because let's say that I decided I wanted to keep the XYZ stock, I sell it for $7,000 and I buy it back for $7,000. If I do this, this is what is known as a wash sale. A wash sale is the sale of a security at a loss and then repurchasing the same or a substantially identical security within 30 days before or after the purchase. So what does that mean for us? It means don't do it, because if we do, we lose the option to write off that loss. So a couple things we need to think about here. Substantially identical. What does that mean? So let's say I had that XYZ tech stock and I lost 3,000, but I didn't want to be out of tech completely for 30 days. I could reinvest that into, let's say, ETF that tracks technical stocks. Maybe I could invest in QQQ, the NASDAQ index, or some other ETF or mutual fund that tracks tech stocks. After 31 days, I could sell that and rebuy my XYZ tech stock. So I would still have some of the same securities that I sold, even though it's not identical. Now, one thing also to think about is if you have, for example, let's say I'm a big fan of VTSAX, the Vanguard Total Stock Market Index. I hold it in my Roth. I do not hold it in my taxable account. And the reason that is if I were to sell it at a loss, and let's say that the dividend, quarterly dividend, reinvested into the VTSAX in my Roth account, even though they're separate accounts, it could still cause a wash sale. So what do I do about that? I keep VTSAX in my Roth, and in my taxable account, I have VV. VV is the Vanguard Large Cap Index ETF. Holds most of the same stocks, you guys. Very close. Doesn't have the small ones, it's all big, but it tracks pretty close in how they end up in the end of the year. So let's say, for example, now the thing to remember is short-term losses are the ones we prefer, because short-term losses will offset short-term gains first. Now let's say that you don't have any short-term gains, although if you have dividends or other things like that, those are all short-term initially, right? Now, if you don't have any short-term capital gains, it will go towards long-term capital gains. So if you have any of those, you can write those up to $3,000 per year. Now, let's say, for example, that I bought and hold, and even though I have some appreciation, I don't have any capital gains this year to use my losses against. I can actually use $3,000 worth of losses against my ordinary income from work. So it can lower my taxable income by $3,000. What if we have a long-term loss? What if we didn't catch it in time? Now, long-term losses are going to be used to go against long-term capital gains. This is why every year, somewhere towards the end of November, first part of December, look at your taxable account and see what you have for losses. Now, if it's $50, maybe it's not worthwhile. But if it's over $1,000, you guys, that's enough money to actually make a difference on your tax bill. So I'm not giving you tax advice here. If you have a question about this stuff, make sure you talk to a tax professional, because if you do it wrong, the tax man can come after you. Now, it's actually pretty simple how this works, you guys. Remember, if I sell a stock, I cannot buy the same stock or a substantial identical one for 30 days. The other thing to remember is if I just bought it less than 30 days ago and then I sell it, it's still in that window, right? Remember, 30 days prior to selling, 30 days after the selling. All right, you guys, I hope you got something out of this. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel, it really helps me out. We're starting to get a fair following. If you have any questions or comments or something you'd like to see, leave them down below. I try to respond to all comments and I make a couple videos a week. We'll see you next time. Thanks.